He's an American painter who has traveled to the four corners of the world to help usher in the prophetic future of the Jewish people and the state of Israel. And we are so happy to bring Jeffrey Hakes here with us, who has a beautiful work of art with him. Hello and welcome.
Thank you.
To the show. Thank and it's really great. Much. We've had a lot of conversation, you know, leading up to this interview. First of all, you know, you and your wife left America, took your children, went to Africa doing humanitarian work. What was it about kind of your search for higher meaning that led to this big move in your life?
We had really, a question can change your whole future. We had the right question placed in front of us, where in reference to a lot of the problems that we're facing sub-Saharan Africa, we were presented with the question, why not you and why not now? And so we felt like, well, we could really help with the needs of children. And so we ended up becoming a part of what was taking place in the wake of the AIDS crisis in sub-Saharan Africa. But behind me, really an anchor from scripture for our work and for casting a vision as we shared across the United States
and in Canada. And this was through the Ezekiel 37, which is something from the Old Testament, prophetic. What was it about this verse
It's an amazing text, and it's really about a puzzle that's broken and scattered, and it's like impossible that it could ever come together. But then through the miracle of the breath of God coming out, all these pieces of this puzzle come back together in Ezekiel 37. And I felt like that was a good vision to cast for people
about
Africa.
Ezekiel is, it is part of the Old Testament. It is basically like, bringing back the people of Israel and the shattered community and bringing it back together. So what was it about your interaction with the people in these African communities that led to this project? You didn't go to Africa expecting to be in Israel.
No, we went to Africa and got involved really just in practical ways to pour out love and in advocacy to help, AIDS orphans and so on, people that wouldn't ordinarily have access to education programs. One of them wrote to us last week. He just graduated from medical school. He's a doctor. Last year, another one of ours graduated from law school.
When you start seeing the fruits of your labor.
Yeah.
Okay, so where did your interest in, Israel
sure.
start? Because you
Excellent
started
question.
With doing a project for the people of Sderot, which is like so close to Gaza. Yeah. How did this come about?
Well, while in Africa, just this awakening came to us that, that text you're using as an inspiration for your work in Africa is really about a specific place, a specific time, and the specific needs of specific people, and that's Israel. And we just felt the invitation to come and be a part. Also now in a practical way and in advocacy for a miracle that's taking place here, and have been traveling, like you said, to the four corners of the earth as advocates and as visual artists also to invite people into what miracle is taking place here.
How did the people of Sderot, which was also very impacted by the war, this was the year before, how did they respond?
Excellent.
You met with the mayor. Were they like, what, a Christian American who loves us so much?
Yes. I stepped out of the car for that engagement, and the mayor's assistant helped me, met me, and greeted me like I was showing up for a family reunion that I had, had been too long avoiding. Just huge warmth and an embrace. And I had some experience with PTSD, with post-traumatic stress. It really dominated my life for a significant amount of time. And it was the powerful scriptures of the Old Testament that really helped to bring my mind back to a steady, equilibrious place.
And what your purpose is.
Yeah.
So let's talk about the project at hand. So this is a project that you literally traveled the world, the literal four corners.
Yeah.
Tell us about it and how you chose the places that you chose and explain this beautiful painting.
Well, I had been speaking for several years in advocacy for Israel, saying, if you don't have time to read all the books and go to all the conferences about what God is doing in Israel, at least read through this text, Ezekiel 37, 1 through 14, and say, breath of God, breathe on these bones. Come from the four corners of the earth and breathe on Israel that she may live. That's right from this text. So then at one point, I really felt like we were supposed to go literally to those places. So we just pulled out a map and felt like Japan is one place that we should go to, and New Zealand, and we went to Chile. And we went to Alaska, and in each of these places we gathered together indigenous peoples and asked them to pray for Israel. Just cast a vision for them being a part of releasing hope and life and love and really getting on board with a faith-filled movement.
Well, it really is so inspiring. I mean, we have, the pictures from your trip and them like engraving their names, and you have Japanese kids blowing the shofar. Did you find that once you went there, like they were just like felt so thrilled to be part of something that, is about spreading light, love, and
To be honest with you, at first I was like, how do I know how to even do this? But I felt like it was just to be done with faith like a child. you know, and so that's what we did. We didn't worry about doing it right or wrong. We just felt like we should go and do kind of a resurrection party.
Wow.
And that's what this is about.
So tell us this painting, and tell us a little bit about it.
In Ezekiel's writings, there are four stages that he mentions. That first, the scattered and broken and lifeless bones come together. So we have the skeletal here. And then the next stage was the sinews come together. And each of these is a stage of the restoration of Israel, really. And then muscles and skin came together, and then they were an army awaiting to receive the breath of God.
Wow.
So this literally is Ezekiel 37 here on this shield, and then it says, "Come breathe on us that we may live."
So it's really beautiful.
The glass on the side, we did a special blue to represent the water that's separating still these pieces coming together. And then, as you mentioned, the names from all these people. Etched in this to
really
be a
beautiful.
Part of just us.
Jeffrey,
we
keep
love
spreading
you,
light and love and praying. You live in Jerusalem. We love you.